If you use Apple Mail, whether it's on your Mac, iPhone, or iPad, then this is the class for you. Today, I'm going to teach you my top 5 Apple Mail tricks. And if you saw the version of this video that I made several years ago, trust me, this one's better. And who knows, I might even throw in a few extras at the end. So be sure to watch the whole video. That's coming up next on Tech Talk America. If you're like most people, cleaning up your email inbox is probably right up there with attending your kid's parent-teacher conference or going to the DMV. I get it. Hopefully, these next 5 tricks will elevate that experience to PTA meeting. Hey, it's an improvement. Do me one quick favor before we begin. Take a look at how many messages you currently have in your inbox and let me know what that number is down below in the comments section. My guess is by the time you're done watching this video and applying the tricks that I'm about to teach you, that number is going to drop dramatically. I'd like to start by teaching you 2 straightforward tricks that are perfect for anyone who has an ungodly amount of email in their inbox. So, most of you. At number 5, I suggest that you use the column view to help clean out old emails based on who they're from, by date, and more. To access this view setting, click into the View menu and select Use Column Layout. Now, let's change the sort order to display messages based on who they're from. What's great about this view is it makes it really easy to select large groups of messages that are all from the same business or person, and then deal with them accordingly, which usually means deleting. Tip number 4 is for any of you out there who qualify as e-hoarders, AKA anyone with a legit fear of deleting old emails. You know who you are. Instead, you can move your emails into a mailbox and then export it out of Apple Mail. Think of this as the digital equivalent of renting a storage unit. It keeps the data safe, but at least it gets it out of the house so you can move. To create a new mailbox, go into the Mailbox menu at the top menu bar and then select New Mailbox. When it asks you for the location, change it to On My Mac. I would recommend that you create 1 mailbox for every year of email. If you try to put too much into one, it can create some problems. Because this is a demo account, I'm just going to create 1 for everything that's over a year old. Now I can select all of the messages that fit into that time frame and drag and drop them into my newly created mailbox. One of the things that's important to be careful about during this next step is you don't want to rush your computer, especially if you have a lot of messages that you're moving. So to understand when your computer is done moving those messages into the mailbox, click into the Window menu and then click on Activity. As you can see here, mine did it in pretty much 2 seconds, but I wasn't moving a lot of messages. Yours may take longer. Don't move on to the next step until it's done. By the way, the shortcut for the activity window is Command-Option-0. Let's now export that mailbox out of Apple Mail by going back to the Mailbox menu and click on Export Mailbox. For this demo, I'm going to save it to the desktop, but if you're doing this for yourself, you'd probably want to save it to an external hard drive, a flash drive, or some sort of cloud service. I'm now going to delete those messages out of Apple Mail, and let's say a year or two goes by, and suddenly I need to access those messages. All I need to do is go to File, click on Import Mailbox, and then when it asks you this question, just go with the Apple Mail option. Then after a few seconds, it imports my data, and I can find all of those messages here in the sidebar. At number 3, I want to turn you onto a handy app that works really well with Apple Mail on both macOS and iOS. The name of the app is Paste. This app is perfect for anyone who frequently uses copy and paste between devices. How many times do you need to access something that you copied to the clipboard in the recent past, such as an hour ago, yesterday, or last week? Paste unlocks your clipboard history so that you can see everything that you copied on all of your devices and syncs your data through iCloud. Heads up, Paste is a subscription service, but it's only $15 a year for the personal plan, so I feel like it's pretty reasonable. Trust me, if you use copy and paste in your normal daily workflow, it's worth checking out. At number 2, I've got a great solution to give your email signature a much needed makeover. You know those really slick professional looking signatures that you often see in emails from people who work at large corporations? Well, you can create your own signature for free at signaturehound.com. First, set up a free account, which is only necessary so that you can install the same signature on each device. They have a few different templates that you can choose from, and it's really easy to add things like your photo or logo, links to social media accounts, and even a custom legal disclaimer. One of the things that most people struggle with is an overwhelming amount of junk mail. That's why my number one tip is that you do two things. Consider creating a new @icloud.com email address, and at the same time, take advantage of the new Hide My Email feature. That way, when you do get on mailing lists in the future, you can totally shut down access to the address they have on file. And if they sell your info, that gets blocked too. To create an @icloud.com email address, if you're on a Mac, just go into System Preferences and click on Apple ID. If you're on iOS, go into Settings, tap on your name at the top, and then tap on iCloud. Now, all you need to do is turn on iCloud Mail, and it will walk you through the process of creating a new email address. You will, of course, want to give that email address to your legit friends and business contacts, but when it comes to companies and online accounts, here's what to do. Let's say I'm browsing around on the web and I find something that I want to purchase. Instead of providing my real email address, I'm going to go back to the Hide My Email settings and create an alias. Instead of going to Settings, tapping on my name, and then tapping into iCloud, you can save yourself a step by using Siri. Just say, "Hey Siri, show me iCloud settings." Now I'll tap into Hide My Email and tap Create a New Address. As you can see here, it has created a totally random email address that I can copy into the clipboard and submit in lieu of the real address. I'm going to type the name of the associated business into the label section just so I can remember where I used this alias. If this company emails the address I just provided, it will forward it to my real email, but I can shut down that ability at any time. So let's say a few weeks from now, they start emailing me daily. All I have to do is come back here to the Hide My Email settings, tap on my card for this business, and then tap on Deactivate Email Address. Let's explore a different scenario. Let's say that this business sells my email address to a marketing company. If they had my real email address, I would have no way to be able to block those additional junk messages from coming in. But because they're pointing to an alias, when I deactivate this account, it would block all of those other senders as well. This is an example of how to use Hide My Email when creating a new account, but in the future, you might want to consider updating some of your other online accounts and reference Hide My Email addresses. Like I said, junk mail is really hard to stop, but by training yourself to not give out your real email address and only hand out aliases, this will dramatically cut down on the amount of junk you receive. Hey, you remember how I told you this was gonna be a top 5 video? Well, guess what? I have two more additional tricks that I wanna share with you right after this quick sponsored message. Today's video is brought to you by our friends at softwarekeep.com. Are you one of those people who's still paying a yearly fee for Microsoft Office? Let me give you a little piece of advice. Stop! You can get a lifetime license for a fraction of the cost when you use my special coupon code TECH20YT. That'll save you 20% off anything you buy on the entire website. Okay, ready for, Okay, ready for a few bonus tricks? Here we go. If you use email for business, you might want to check out a plugin for Apple Mail called Mail Butler. This integrates right into Apple Mail and adds several advanced features. For example, the ability to schedule an email to be sent at a later date and time. And you can even get a notification when the person receiving the message actually opens it. Mail Butler has free and paid options, and the features that I just told you about are both included in the free version. If you want to check out Mail Butler, visit mailbutler.io. Okay, before we go, I have one last really simple trick. This is not a new feature by any means, but if you didn't know about this setting, it's probably driving you bat crazy. Have you ever noticed that even if you turn off notifications for Apple Mail via the notifications panel in System Preferences, it still makes this sound every time you get a new email? Super annoying, right? We got the idea? All you have to do to stop it is go into Apple Mail's preferences, click into the General tab, and turn this setting to none. Please take a quick moment to hit that like button, leave me a little comment down below, and if you haven't already done so, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.